I don't like that slithering behind
looks
a
skull. Looks like a Gucci campaign. Well, yes. I don't know how I know that. Anyway, it's...
Heard it again.
Well, it's every parent's worst nightmare. This is the moment Melbourne mum and Daniela Vicini noticed a brown snake. A brown snake or a brown snake? Anyway, we'll find out in a second. Slithering through her backyard, metres away from her young daughter who was splashing in the pool, completely and utterly oblivious.
Oh, God, it's terrifying. And it really is heart-stopping stuff. Daniela joins us live from Melbourne. Layla in Melbourne's north. Daniela, we've got your husband Matthew there as well. And, of course, Eva and Dallara. Hello, fam. Now, Daniela, you know, we know it was a very warm day in Melbourne yesterday, but this isn't exactly what you expect to see down there. More like a Queensland kind of vibe, right?
Right. Well, we were shocked and quite scared, actually. It was a split-second moment, really, and a reaction that just shocked us all.
Because it looked to me like oh, that's what we just saw there in your reaction. It looked to me like you were very busy doing something before you saw the snake, and then you have this reaction. Can we play that bit? Here we go.
Yeah.
So you're busy. What are you doing there?
So I was on the phone with one of my friends who lives across the road, and I was saying,
"Oh my God,
bring your girls over so that we can, like, girls can play in the water." And then, that never happened. And then before I knew it, I was yanking Eva out of the water so fast. So just, oh, it was terrifying.
And you left Eva's arm in the pool, it looks like.
How it's still on, I don't know.
You didn't tear it from its socket. That is fortunate.
So you've not seen anything like that. Matt, obviously, you're the smartest in the family, just nowhere near the action. But when you found out or saw the vision, have you seen anything like this around the house before?
Well, I think last year it was.
Yeah.
We did see one just on our nature strip on this side.
Oh, really?
Where it called the Wild Dog. Yeah, so that was a bit scary as well. No, I heard Daniela scream and I was under the alfresco, and we're Italian, so I just thought she was talking normally. So I didn't really take notice of it. Then when I heard snake, I was up and about trying to get inside and make sure everyone was safe.
You know, because everyone in... Look, Sarah's right. Everyone in Cairns, you know, where I grew up, is going, why is this even a story?
this happened to me. Look, let me tell you, in Laylaw, this is very uncommon. I mean, you saw one last year, but they don't just hang around suburban Melbourne, these brown snakes.
That's right. This is very unique and orthodox situation. So, I get all the people up north will be going, oh, these city slickers, but this is very unusual for us.
And look, the Italians in Griffith would handle this in a very different way.
I don't think we can say it on the news, Carl.
We definitely
Carl
have
says
got
what he likes.
An issue with the grass at the moment around the area.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Out of control.
The council isn't really doing anything about it fast enough.
Hang on a second. A council not doing anything except build stupid art.
Spend $80,000.
Yeah. Yes, exactly. So hopefully they can get their act together. Oh,
indeed. We'll get you on again to talk about councils, Daniela, because I've got a few.
Sure.
And Matt's probably a little bit sick of it, but we love it. Hey, I'm glad everything's safe and sound. Eva, are you okay, love? What happened?
What happened?
Snake. Yeah.
What a beautiful little girl.
She is cute. Beautiful family. Glad you guys are all right.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us this morning.
What story.